In this video, we're going to talk about simultaneous diagonalization of two operators. So the situation is that you have two operators on a vector space V, and we're assuming that both of them are diagonalizable. So you could find a basis of eigenvectors of A, and that would make handling A really nice, but they might not be eigenvectors of B. Or you could find a basis of eigenvectors of B, and that would be great, but they wouldn't be eigenvectors of A. And we would like to have our cake and eat it too. We would like to ask, does there exist a basis consisting of eigenvectors of both A and B? In other words, if you work in the basis B, every basis vector is an eigenvector of A, let's say with eigenvalue lambda I, and it's also an eigenvector of B, with maybe a different eigenvalue, but it's the same eigenvector. And that means that if you work in the B basis, A winds up being diagonal, and B winds up being diagonal. And that's why we call it simultaneous diagonalization of A and B. In this situation, we say A and B are simultaneously diagonalizable. Okay, so for example, let's look at the matrices 2, 1, 1, 2, and 3, 4, 4, 3. Now, they both have eigenvectors 1, 1, and 1, minus 1. If you multiply, this is our favorite matrix. We've seen that multiplying this by 1, 1 gives you 3, 3, and 1, minus 1 gives you 1, 1, minus 1. And likewise, 1, 1 and 1, minus 1 are eigenvectors of B. 1, 1 is an eigenvector with eigenvalue 7, and 1, minus 1 is an eigenvector with eigenvalue negative 1. If you work in the B basis, you find that the matrix of A in the B basis is 3, 0, 0, 1. Matrix of B is 7, 7, 0, minus 1. And now we discover something interesting about products. If you multiply A times B, you get 10, 11, 11, 10. And if you multiply B times A, you get the same thing. And that shouldn't be too surprising because this matrix and this matrix commute. They're both diagonal. The matrix of AB or the matrix of BA in the B basis is just this matrix times this matrix, and that's 21, 0, 0, negative 1. Now, this is a general occurrence. So here's the rule about simultaneous diagonalization. Two matrices, if they're both diagonalizable, they're simultaneously diagonalizable if and only if they commute. Now, this is a really big theorem. It won't fit in one video. We're going to break it up into pieces. In this video, we'll show that if they're simultaneously diagonalizable, then they have to commute. We'll also show that if they commute and if all the eigenvalues of A have multiplicity 1, then the eigenvectors of A are also eigenvectors of B, and we're done. We just take the eigenvectors of A and we win. That's actually what happened in the example that we did before. We found the eigenvalues of A, 3 and 1. The eigenvectors are 1, 1, and 1, minus 1. And boom, they're also eigenvectors of B. And then in the next video, we'll deal with the case where A might have eigenvalues with higher multiplicity. That's harder. We can make it work. But it involves more work, and it's best left for another day. So let's suppose that things are simultaneously diagonalizable. Then A in the B basis is a diagonal matrix. B in the B basis is also a diagonal matrix, different entries, but they're both diagonal matrices. And if you multiply diagonal matrices in either order, you get the same thing. But A in the B basis times B in the B basis is AB in the B basis. And B in the B basis times A in the B basis is BA in the B basis. So AB in the B basis is the same thing as BA in the B basis. And that means that AB has to be BA to begin with. The only way that two matrices will have the same, two operators will have the same matrix in the B basis is if they were the same operator to begin with. And that's theorem one. If they're simultaneously diagonalizable, then they commute. So let's prove the converse in the case that A has all the eigenvectors have multiplicity 1. So let's suppose we have an eigenvector of A. In other words, A times this vector gives you a lambda times the vector. I claim that if you multiply B times that vector, you also get an eigenvector of A with the same eigenvalue. And the way to check that is you say A times BB. Is AB times B? Is BA times B because AB equals BA? But A times B is just lambda B. Lambda is a constant. You pull it out. You get lambda times BB. So A times BB is lambda times BB. In other words, BB is an eigenvector of A with eigenvalue lambda. But we assume that the multiplicity was 1. So there is only one eigenvector with eigenvalue lambda up to scale. So BB has to be a multiple of B. In other words, B is an eigenvector of big B. And I apologize for using the letter B in three different ways, once for the basis vector, once for the operator, and once for the basis. But that's the way it is.